Sorry, I will start as soon as I am back from the bathroom. Hopefully that's not long. I'm really sorry, guys. Okay, I'm back. I will say I'm just in a weird mood today, friends. So if I seem not myself, I can't quite figure out what it is, that's bothering me, but yeah. Hopefully hopefully stream goes well and I can kind of keep it together, but all right, let's get Scarlet Hollow going. We are going on to episode 3, and I realized I never read the content warnings for episode 2. Here we are. Okay. Okay. Episode 3. Amputation, child amputation, unreality, hanging, implied parental abuse, mild jump scares, substance abuse, disturbing imagery and situation, stalking, auditory gore, murder. Okay. Sorry, I'm just texting my mom. All right. Yeah, so that's episode 3. I mean, the warnings for episode 4 are absolutely insane. Like, basically, you could take all the warnings from episodes 1, 2, and 3, and I'm not sure that they would still add up to the same length of the warnings for episode 4. I mean, ooh, we are in for it. But let's get into it. Oh, there we go. Yes, I have makeup on. I felt like being a human. I also might try and actually wear makeup on stream, because I own a lot of makeup, and I don't really use it much anymore, and I want to do that, so. Alright, load. Yep. We did that. Yes, let's recap. Yeah, let's do the full recap. The long-lost cousin, the bad news, the 26 hours of bus rides with countless late-night stops and CD depots that would have felt unsafe even in the middle of the day. You wouldn't normally find yourself traveling like this, but your cousin bought the tickets. The funeral of Pearl and Scarlet, your cousin's mother and your aunt, seemed like something you shouldn't ignore, even considering your own late mother's rocky relationship with this side of the family. Welcome to our family's humble estate. Unfortunately, due to the current state of the house, only a few rooms will be safely accessible during your stay. I wouldn't go wandering anywhere else if you value your limbs. The floors have been known to give out. A single deer remains behind. Let me skip these. Staring down the beam of Stella's flashlight, while Gretchen whines and pulls at her harness. Oh yes, the freaky deer. Come on, you, whatever your name is, grab that flashlight and help me line up a good shot. As the creatures in the tree line grow louder and more numerous, Gretchen violently strains against her harness. You dive forward and scoop Gretchen into your arms, just before she manages to wiggle out of her harness. Your eyes fixate on the dark tree line over Doom's shoulder. God damn it! Stella, keep an eye on them for us. Make sure they don't get into any more trouble. Yeah, because they think I did it, even though we have it on video. Makes no sense. My grandmother called them ditchlings, and they are a terrible omen, a sign of great suffering and destruction to come. You know, when you think about it, one little mind collapse doesn't really warrant the ditchlings being around. From the relative safety of your cousin's uncomfortable guest bed, the events of the past evening seem like something that happened to someone else, though you can still clearly picture the terror you felt in those moments. For now, you're safe and you're warm. But listen, you better stay out of trouble today. I want you home by sunset.
Well,
I don't want to hear complaints. Just do what I ask and you won't have any more problems. Tabitha takes a few steps towards the door. Sunset. Winnie can fix you some of Sybil's new blend. Maybe it'll calm me down a bit. Oh boy, we might be getting to a point where my mom is going to eventually watch, stream, and be in the chat. How fun. I think you'll like today's mix. It's Chaga and Lemon Balm. Should help ease your stress and tension. And if you feel like talking, I'll be all ears. Have either of you seen Rosalina around town? I don't want to be a helicopter dad, but she hasn't been answering my texts, and I wanted to make sure she isn't getting into trouble out there. Oh, don't worry, Oscar! She was running around in the fucking mine! The collapsed mine, where 160 people died. I'm literally snoozing the ads. Hi, Dr. Kelly. We were wondering if it would be okay if Reese could come hang out. Nothing strenuous, we promise. Whatever you two have planned is probably beyond what he can manage right now, anyways. Okay, bye. Stay home. Wait for the week to end. Don't keep putting yourself in the path of danger. This is all I ask. As you leave Tabitha's office, you take a moment to get your bearings, only to be interrupted by a sudden movement out of the corner of your eye. A girl carrying a bundle of snacks pops through a hole in the fence and disappears over the crest of a hill. Fucking Rosalina. She didn't. I guess the old Maxwell place doesn't cut it as a secret spot these days. But the Shaw Mine? That place was shut down like 100 years ago, after a collapse that killed over 100 people. Yeah, including children, because they had children working in the mine. Pull out your phone and dial your cousin. What is it? You know I'm in a meeting. A kid just snuck into the Shaw Mine. I figured you should know. Are you serious? Why do things keep happening to me? Whatever. I'll head over there as soon as I can. Stay where you are and wait for me. Don't even know why I'm trying to reason with you. It's not like you'll listen. Yeah, exactly, because I didn't wait. My dad is a foreman at the continuous mining facility. He says they only abandoned this mine because there wasn't enough coal left. So it's actually really safe, and we can hang out here whenever we want. Yeah, that's why I collapsed. Your father was a foreman at the continuous mining facility. We'll see if he even has a job tomorrow morning. My dad says our house is haunted. Because that's clearly important. They would include it in the recap. I didn't think it mattered, but obviously. Is interrupted by a pair of thunderous knocks. You see Becca and Alexis gone, and Rosalina anxiously hovering in front of a small tunnel in the cavern wall. She freezes as you notice her. There's something in the darkness before you that's much louder, though you don't hear it, but you can feel it in your chest, like the deep growl of a predator. What do you think you're doing? Get away from me. Cousin dives towards you, but not before the light from your phone illuminates the chamber. The miners. Are you alright? You and Tabitha manage to squeeze through the entrance just as the walls of the mine come crashing down. Holy shit, you're okay. Thank God. And everyone's accounted for. That was a surprisingly close call. could have all died down there. What did you weirdos do? Everything was fine until you adults showed up. Becca, shut up. Oh yeah, they got into a fight. Tabitha doesn't say a word. Yep. You go to bed. After your time in the Shaw mine, you barely even notice the dust. I can't remember. You see the when you close your eyes, you see the shadowy figures that gathered behind Stella in the mines. Your thoughts are drawn to the carving on the wall, to the visions it imparted upon you. Oh yeah. Your thoughts are drawn. Oh yeah. Wake up. Sunshine filters in through the dusty windows of the estate as the dull aches of last night's activities throb in and out of focus. You manage to survive a second night in the town of Scarlet Hollow. As you pull yourself out of bed, you can feel the soot and grime of the Shaw mine still stuck on your skin. Ew, you didn't go. You went to bed? Oh, I mean, shit, this shower isn't gonna make you feel much cleaner, is it? You can't go a whole week without showering. Water's hot and clean. The steam fills your lungs and so washes down the drain. You, every minute feels like another thread holding this town together starts to unravel. Thoughts of doom. Oh. Nope. We're not gonna think about Duke with his head blown off. Nope, scrub. Scrape the memories. Yeah, because like we didn't take a shower after we watched Duke got murdered. This is our first shower of the whole game. Think about Wayne. Think about someone special. Alright, well, I hope I get more than one choice. Oh, I don't. Wash away your sins. Time to start your day. Explore. Nobody creepy. There's two. Enter the kitchen and find your cousin in the midst of devouring a pint of banana chocolate chunk. She isn't alone. Frufru glares at you from her usual spot on the counter as a red-haired woman busies herself trying to tidy as best she can. Tabitha's eyes dart to the corner of the room, almost as if she's ashamed of being caught in the act of stress-eating ice cream for breakfast. Hi. Good morning, I'm Janie. I'm just here to do my little weekly cleaning, whatever cleaning Miss Tabitha will let me do. I could have this place looking brand new, you know. Don't go making any big renovations or moving anything around. I like knowing where my stuff is. Okie dokie. So nice to finally meet you, Steffi. I mean, I guess I did meet you on Monday when you popped into the diner. But seeing someone somewhere and meeting them face to face are two completely different things, I suppose. Thanks. All I'm trying to say is that it's wonderful to finally actually meet you, and I'm so happy part of the family is here to help Miss Tabitha, to keep Miss Tabitha company, what with everything that's Janie. I'm sorry, Miss Tabitha. Am I being too much again? Tabitha grumbles and acknowledges it. Tabitha, yeah, let's keep it. Massive mind collapse last night that almost got my cousin killed. I'm a little stressed. Tabitha takes one last spoonful of ice cream that discards the empty container, turning to you with her trademark scowl. Let's get going. I've got an errand to run in town, and every time I've left you here alone, something terrible's wound up happening. So you're coming with me. I'm not gonna fight it. It's fine. Lock up when you leave, please. Don't go rearranging anything. I'll know. Well, that sucks. Jenny looks a lot like somebody that I used to know. I really wish she didn't look like that. As you're ready to leave, Janie approaches from the far side of the kitchen. Tabitha remains between the two of you, impatiently tapping her foot. I didn't notice how much she looked like this person until she got closer. Heard about what happened last night. I mean, I heard about it before Miss Tabitha mentioned it, and then I heard it again. I just wanted to say I'm so sorry you got caught up in that. You two did right by the kids, though. What a blessing, everyone getting out of that situation all right. Last night was an unavoidable tragedy, but I'm afraid there's more to explore. That sounds dreadful. Have you considered stopping by the church? Ugh, not the church. My husband's the pastor, and he's been going absolutely stir-crazy since we've moved here. What, with nobody really attending? Good. Probably do him a lot of good to talk you through your worries. I used to talk with all sorts of people he likes to extend. No. Feel free to stop by the church. No. What do you do with the rest of your time if you only come in once a week? Odd jobs, weeding gardens, cleaning houses, watching kids. Enough dawdling, we're leaving. You and Tabitha walk through the doors of the estate and get in the car. The ride to town is uneventful, your cousin unsurprisingly more focused on the road than on making conversation. Typical. We're just popping into the general store for a few minutes. What are we doing here? Picking up tea. Yeah. Yeah, it's nice to just do something normal, like get some fucking tea at the store. It's nice to just go on an errand. Smart. You and Tabitha turn as the door to the general store bursts open. A flustered Kanika exits, shouting behind her. Fine, okay, keep coddling him. Keep letting him get away with stuff you never would have let me so much as think about. I'm sick of carrying this family. Ooh. Kanika storms off. The door slowly drifting shut behind her. Oh no. Other people in their drama. If more people kept things to themselves, they'd be a lot happier. Listen! Surprised by my question. Oh. The lessons we learn from loss are often more powerful than those we learn from victory. I hate you. I'm unhappy because I took too long to learn life's difficult truths. Okay. We're burning daylight, come on. Bells of the general store chime as you cross the threshold. The smell of old wood and steamy herbal tea flood your senses, making you feel instantly at home. Good morning, you two. Hope you're doing well after last night's activities. Morning. Is the new blend ready? Of course. you'd like to keep Miles company, Tabitha and I will be just a minute. Is Kimiko okay? She just needs time to cool down. Emotions are a little high considering everything that happened yesterday. She'll settle down soon enough. I'm just glad both of my little ones made it out okay. Simple motions for Tabitha to follow, and they both disappear into the tea room, closing the door behind them with a tinkling of bells. I'm being nosy, ho. You walk up and listen to me. Your listening session is halted as the tinkling of bells announce another patron. Yes, I'm Steffi. What do you want? Oh, my name is Bo. I'm Duke's boy. It's a pleasure to meet you. The policeman told me you saw what happened to my daddy. Don't say the first one. I'm so sorry. The policeman said he might have just been out hunting somewhere, but me and my mama both know he ain't coming back. Mama's pretty broken up about it. I'm trying to hold it together since I'm the man of the house now, but it ain't easy. He and him were supposed to bring Big Betty to the state fair this week, but now he's gone. And as of this morning, so is she. So I suppose if I'm not going to the fair, I might as well make myself useful and get out in the woods to look for what's left of my daddy. He was there, right? Could you tell me where to look so I can try and find him? Yeah, my guy. I don't think you want to see him like that. It is really, it's bad. I'm a farm boy. This isn't just blood. He's got a huge hole in his fucking head. Even cartoon-wise, it was awful. I just want to find my daddy, even if he's like one of them horror movie monsters. He's still my daddy, and he shouldn't be out in them woods where any animal can take a piece of him. Big Betty, one of your chickens. No, she ain't a chicken. Big Betty is our prized pumpkin. She was a big lady, too. I'd expect she was at least 2,000 pounds. Not too easy to move something like that. Could be she rolled off down a hill, but I can't be looking for her just yet. What with everything else going on? No, it wasn't the ditchling. Seen anything strange on the farm? I've been busy, and chickens keep disappearing. Oh, I didn't mean to hit that. Stella overslept. Gotta make myself breakfast. Y'all say bye. Meet a library. Just had a big fight. Not really hungry. Gonna chill in my van for a while if you wanna hang out though. Otherwise, see you at the library. Plenty of time before dinner. Go to Kanika's. Swing by Stella's. Check in on Oscar. Go to the diner to see Avery. Wait for Tabitha. Doesn't take long to make your way to Stella's. Oh. Yeah. Sorry, I'm a mess. I guess I slept in a lot. Give me a minute to finish getting dressed and I can make us some breakfast. Stella talks from the other room as she changes. What are you feeling for breakfast? Pancakes, eggs, and biscuits, maybe just a classic scramble. I also have toast or waffles if that's more your speed. Offering biscuits after I've had one of Winnie's. Someone's got a snow. It's weird. If it was like a waffle, not a toaster waffle, forget it. Nothing like a stack of cakes for breakfast. We don't need the fur. This jumpsuit because we're ghost hunting later. Yeah. Yep, this used to be my lucky getup from back when I did ghost hunting videos. Guess you might call it unlucky since I've never actually seen a ghost. But hey, after the past couple of nights, maybe we can use a bit of bad luck. The kind of bad luck where we don't find anything, of course. Don't want to jinx us. Should we start on food? Let's get started. Pancakes are pretty easy, though the real challenge is not burning them. Yeah, that's what I wanted. And not undercooking them. As Stella starts work on her egg. Seems like you got an earlier start than I did. Anything interesting happen while I was asleep? Did Tabby give you a hard time? Met Bo at the general store. Tabitha was planning on babysitting me all day, but I managed to slip off while she was picking up tea. I hope I can see two things. Ghost hunting. After everything we've been through, I'm pretty nervous.
Yeah.
This is the normal people response. Adventuring in an abandoned mine. Don't say it. See how even a legit haunting would be anywhere near as bad as everything that happened to us yesterday or the day before. I think we're in for a chill evening. This is just like you and Tabitha's mom. Just because you like getting scared doesn't mean other people do. You've convinced me tonight will be fun. Stella, please don't say it'll be chill. You're gonna jinx it. You keep saying things are gonna be chill and then they're not chill. You're right, it'll be fun. I guess that's starting to become a pattern. Thank you. Even if it's not chill, it's gotta get done. Oscar and Rosalina need their house back. Eggs are done, time for the cookies. Stella takes your bowl from you, dumping it into her flour, and whisking quickly to combine the ingredients. Okay. Stella takes her bowl from you, dumping it into her flower. Yeah. Now we pray to the pancake gods for a perfect snack stack. Jesus. Thanks for coming over, by the way. It's nice to have company. I'm gonna do the first one. Dated. About Avery. Them very well. Huh. I grew up really skinny contact. Is this a stranger with whom you're related to? I moved here a few years ago, kind of lost some feelings about stuff with the accent, and it wasn't really in the right headspace for making me You don't say. Better circumstances would be nice. Dr. Kelly tries to turn us away again. We can just sneak in. Nothing will stand in the way of us and friendship. What's he like? I'm not about to ruin a cool, mysterious introduction by telling you. I think you'll like him. I'm sure he's real. Breakfast is served. And look, I didn't burn any of them. The pancake gods wanted to make sure I could impress my guest with incredible breakfast skills. Bon appetit. I've been having a bit of a hard time sleeping the past couple of nights, so I'm sure you can relate. I think I needed a nice, slow morning like this, just hanging out. As you and Stella start to dig in, you're interrupted by a phone alarm. It's Mayor Jimmy Day. On top of being a great show, it's probably a good excuse to meet up with Oscar and start talking ghosts. Christian barks at the mention of Mayor Jimmy. We can warn him of the coming danger. Why is meeting the mayor such an exciting event to you? He's just a politician. You should let Avery know. Okay, library for Mayor Jimmy Day is what I think we're about to... How charming can you be? Yep, okay. Okay, we're at the library. We are not any... Oh my gosh. We're gonna have to... I'm gonna end up having... carry on for forever, but we will try. You and Stella make your way to the library. It's busier than usual. A small crowd is already formed in the corner of the main foyer. Okay, now we're just waiting for Kanika. I just thought of something. Hold on. Sleepy, but I've only been live for like an hour. So. Oopsie. Thank you. What? The mayor is always a dog. Oh my God. He holds out his paw as if to shake your hand. True Deputy Franklin, it's lovely to meet you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Mayor, something terrible is going to happen to this town. We need your help. He's a dog, he's so cute. Paw shaking. Well, he held it out. Gretchen, chill. Creepy pastor. Pastor Daniel. I hate when people say that shit. Oh, I'm sure they're in a better place. Dow Perlian's in a better place. Sounds like she was awful. Let's kid ourselves. Counseling from you. Creepy ass guy. Someone's going to see a fucking dog mayor. Oscar, why are you dressed like that in the library? What's going on? Going in until that spirit is at full power. What? Oh, yeah. I'm sucking on a candy cane. That's why I turned the camera off. But it's helping me stay awake. I think that is the most important thing. It's blueberry flavored. The death of me. We have the power of friendship on our side. Hell no. I love Kanika's shirt. Met the creepy pastor. Bad vibes. That bothered me so much. We're allowed to dislike him, even though he hasn't done anything. My girl, when did I say that wasn't allowed?
I trust dogs. Why doesn't Gretchen like you, Reese? Wow, Dr. Kelly, don't be so thrilled. Don't be so thrilled. The house feels cold. There's an odd chill in the air. The building itself feels too sterile, uncomfortably tidy. Pouring for the aroma of rolls in the oven. They have convinced he'd wandered into a real estate showing. Sitting down at the table. Okay, don't help. Made sure everything was done well in advance, so the only thing left are the dinner rolls, which shouldn't be long. Then we can have a quick dinner and you can leave my house. Damn, lady! Still have time now, right? You aren't seriously considering subjecting your friends to your disaster of a room, are you? Why do Reese's nails look like that? Not that bad. You can still see the floor. Dr. Kelly raises a single questioning eyebrow. I don't mind a little mess. I doubt it could be any worse than the way I keep mine. As long as you stay out of the kitchen, I don't care. You won't even know we're here. Make your way towards the stairs. Basement is what you might expect out of a tortured artist who spends all his time confined in his studio. Discarded canvases line its edges while trash and sketches leak out from their piles. Bare cement floor. Ghoulish faces coat the walls in paint, sneering out at their creator. Oh my god. Yeah, I don't like this place. Mom is scary. She can be a little intense, kind of overprotective, which I guess makes sense. Anyway, make yourselves comfortable. You'll have to forgive the mess. I've been distracted lately. Haven't been cleaning much. Let's see. Yeah, Stella told you everything. Told me all about what you guys have found out there. I wish I could see some of it myself. Are you sure you can't sneak out one of these nights? Doc isn't keeping me prisoner here, so I'm sick. You know that. Nothing to apologize for, and I appreciate the effort. Really, I do. There's nothing to really you can really rescue me from. That die has already been cast. Talking about the past couple of days, weren't we? Do you have any thoughts on the ditchlings? Do you think the town is doomed? What do you think of my cousin? What's going on with Wayne? They've been coming up to my window. Ugh. Is that why you texted me that they looked like something out of your nightmares? I thought I was hallucinating. I hadn't put it together that we might have been seeing the same thing until just now. I've been sketching them. I've been seeing. Tell me what you think. Wow, where did I get that? Ooh. It's them. Pulls out a sketchbook from one of the piles. Thank you. exactly what I saw on my way home last night. Does it mean they've been lurking around here, though? I don't know, but I like the company. They're kind of beautiful in a sad way. Agree to disagree with you there. Those things are going to be stuck in my nightmares until the day I die, honestly. Everything is probably doomed at some point, but I guess that's answering a different question. Do I think the town of Scarlet Hollow is on the brink of collapse? Probably not, but it's not like I have a lot of perspective on what it's like out there. There could be rioting on Main Street, and if Stella or the doc didn't tell me, I just wouldn't know. I would totally tell you if there was a riot. Would Dr. Kelly tell you though? I mean, yeah, I'd hope so. But the point I'm trying to make is that other people are my eyes out there. What do you think of my cousin? What's going on with Wayne? Okay. Guy's been following Steffi around. Slasher creep. Classic Jason vibe. Doesn't live up to the look. What do you think of my cousin? Always so distant and mean, probably would have thought she had it out for me. Personally, if she wasn't like that towards everyone. Hi, B here. I am good. Playing chapter 3 of this game. Maybe she's nicer now. She's still terrible. Guys, just never took the chance to get to know her. She's actually really funny and sweet. Oh yeah, time. Mom really looks out for you. Your mom is scary. Your whole situation's gotta be rough. Yeah. How are you, Abir? Oh, there's new emotes. I forgot to say that. Where are they? Are the new ones. Dealing with this thing for a while, so you don't have to feel sorry for me. Come to terms with the way the rest of my life is going to be. Yeah, I thought they were kind of a little more accurate for my dark purple hair that I've been rocking. So... of course, yes. And honestly, that isn't even all of them. There are more, but I couldn't use them all. I don't have enough slots. Since death, you haven't. No one knows what's wrong with me, but it's been getting worse. Barely keep most food down. My skin always itches. Live for a long time or a short time. I'm not going to get better. Whatever time I have left is going to be miserable. I've done my mourning. My best years are behind me. Ugh. Future's unknowable. One day I'll wind up in a pine box. Yeah, let's talk about the art. Six units. acting as steel bars, trapping some anguished being within. Yeah, let's be nice. I feel the emotion. Like, I'm channeling whatever's plaguing me into the paint. When they're done, I feel like I've been emptied out. All the vile things inside of me sealed away in the canvas. That's why I make so many of them. Sometimes when I return to a piece, it's almost like I'm offering an invention for those feelings to slither back under my skin. There are some pieces I can't even look at. I hide them until I forget they exist. I'd rather not let those particular feelings back in. Sounds kind of like therapy. That sounds healthy, probably. Yeah, art therapy. It does sound like art therapy. Being empty better must be better than being full of bad thoughts. I think so. It works for me, at least. Movie collection, any recommendations? Usually I understood the, like, what it wanted me to... Head over to Oscar's after this. We promised we'd ghost hunt his place, but apparently he's been dealing with a bad haunting, and I feel like we should really be there for him tonight considering everything that's happened. He and Rosalina both need our support right now. I'll take a rain check on that movie though. Stitch. As much as we did, some kids weren't able to make any friends. It's happening to be born around the same time as some real jerks, and we're stuck with them for their whole school career. Thank you. trying to push through to... Alright, dinner time. I'm allergic, oh my god. Oh my god, okay. Yo, what is up with that door? What is up with the door? brought a dead squirrel in. Okay, we have made it out of dinner, about to start the ghost hunting. Yeah. Probably. Another vision. No. I don't want to break into the clinic. action. Ghost action. Dinner did not go okay. Are you for real? I was confronted with my own mortality for the first time yesterday, so I'm desperate for answers about the afterlife to ease my troubled mind. Why are you surprised that I disappeared and left? Tabitha. It's me. Thank you. Yeah, why hasn't she seen it if it mostly appears in the rooms? Thank you.
Okay.